Well, for those who aren't okay with it, fuck you guys. I'm going to start off by telling you a true story, so here we go. Country shit these days. I'm going to play a song all about that very fact now. It really fucking irritates me the way there's a sort of convention that you're only allowed to play, or you're only allowed to be taken seriously playing kind of country and folk music if you come from America, particularly kind of, you know, America, like the Deep South and that kind of shit. I actually think that's total fucking bullshit, personally. So I wrote a song about that. This song's called Nashville, Tennessee, so here we go. Sound before I'd ever And yes, I'm in four time. And yes, I use cheap rhymes, but I try to make a sound my own. And no, I don't break new ground. Many have traveled this town, but I try to make it sound like home. Well, I've been to Texas State. I didn't think it was that fucking great. And Nebraska, it's just a bunch of songs. All the way in Hampshire, where I belong. And I don't know anybody who plays pedal steel guitar. All the city roads are twisted, and I do not own a car. I was raised in middle England, and not in Nashville, Tennessee. And the only thing I'm offering is me. We'll move swiftly on. This is a song about, okay, hands up who grew up, or considering where we are, possibly still lives in a shitty little fucking crappy butt fuck, you know, incestuous town where everybody's fucking backstabbing little scenes to cunts. Yeah, hands up.
New Shabbats!
Yeah, you know what I'm talking about. All right, well, so did I, and it was totally shit. But I wrote a song about it anyway. So this song's called "This Town Ain't Big Enough for the One of Me," and it goes a little something like this. Anyone here a fan of a band called the Lemonheads?
Hey!
That was a disappointingly small number of people. Next time I play in Kingston, which is in January sometime. Yeah, I'm playing the people in January sometime.
Which one is?
Yeah, okay, well, next time I play, I'm hoping a lot more people... I'm hoping a lot more people will say yes when I ask that question. Not that I'll necessarily play this song again, but I just hope that you will have done your homework and checked out the lyrics. So fucking rule. This is officially my favourite song of all time ever. And it's called The Outdoor Type, so here we go. Which is a very nice and kind of friendly title, and there's nothing wrong with that. However, my friend Steve had the genius to suggest a much better title, which is what I'm going to call it now, which is...
I don't want to hear about your gap year!
Yeah, actually I really don't care where you went on your gap year. That's the new title of this song. So this is a song about how I'm going to be feeling tomorrow morning, so here we go.
Downing dregs of yesterday all the while.
behind the next song I'm going to play. This is a quiet one. And just for those who hadn't figured this out already, right? If you're standing at the front of an acoustic show and you're chatting really loudly with your mates, I can hear, and so can everybody else. So don't, stand somewhere else. All right, there's a story behind the song. This is a song and originally had more time to sell lyrics, which you witnessed. This is about a girl who I used to go out with, who I was very much enamored with. You witnessed it too.
Yeah.
A girl who I was very much in love with, who was from America, and then it turned out that she was a horrible bitch, and that she'd been two-timing me all along. Isn't that the saddest story you've ever heard?
I'm sorry!
What the fuck? Alright. But basically, I wrote a song for her that was all about how I liked her lots, and then I found out she was a horrible bitch, so I changed the words. So you're getting the new version. The song's called Sunshine State, and it's really hard to play, so forgive me if I fuck it up.
Thank you.
I stand corrected. I also stand unable to get my pick out from underneath my cap. Right, okay, two questions. Anyone here heard of Chris TT?
Yes,
I'm gonna play a Chris TT song because it's super. I'm also gonna ask a question. Anyone here country born and bred? Anyone from the countryside?
Westbourne!
Yes! Right! So am I! Wow, we should like hang out and be friends and stuff. And that will do. This song's called The Huntsman Comes a Marching. Personality. I'm actually a thoroughly lovely human being, but but I write songs about how sometimes I'm a bit of a twat. So here we go. This is yet another song on that subject. So here we go. Again, a true story. This comes from New Year's Eve 2004. No, 2003. I'm not going to explain why, but you can draw your own conclusions from the story. It's been 18 months since I kissed you once, so just saying hi just it hasn't gonna fly. But if you give me a clue and a minute or two, then I might remember your name. And I hate to insist that I was really that pissed, but to tell the truth, in my flush of youth, I would drown my sight so the faces and nights seem the same. And another shrug and an awkward hug won't get me out of the hole I've dug. So I slit the noose with a poor excuse and talk to someone, anyone else. And I sit with my friends and I try to pretend that I never did that sort of thing again. But I'm lying to myself. Perfectly in tune. It's gonna be fucking amazing.
You're never gonna get to heaven.
Well, fuck you too, bitch. Right, I got two more songs. The first of this is a song about. This came from a conversation that me and my friend Steve, who's already featured this evening. Do you remember Steve?
Yeah,
he was the one with the song title. Yeah. Alright, me and my friend Steve were chatting about the fact that loads of singer-songwriter types have songs that are written to kind of woo specific girls and go, you know, love me, I'm a wonderful human being. Now you see, the thing is, if you were any good at your trade, you'd only actually have one of those songs because you'd woo her, get her into bed, and that would be the end of the issue, you wouldn't need to write anymore. So the fact of having loads of them means that you're fucking rubbish, essentially, was the conversation we had. And I wrote a song about it, so this song's called Romantic Fatigue, and it goes like this. Yes, I am.
Is that part of the song?
Yeah. Do you like my new avant-garde intro? Here we go. CDs with me which have songs that I've been playing tonight on them. Some people have them. Shut the fuck up. I have CDs with me. If you enjoy what I'm doing and don't already own one, come and talk to me in a minute. I do have to go and catch a train shortly, but I'll be around for a little bit. So come and grab me, give me some love, maybe buy me a few drinks, invite me to a club, maybe take you back to your house. We'll meet up again in about a week's time and I'll give you a CD. What do you reckon? Yeah, okay. Anyway, I'm gonna finish with a song. I used to play in a band.
Yes!
Really?
Yeah, we were called Million Dead. And then we broke up, which was a fatal career though. But that's his way. But I'm gonna finish by playing a Million Dead song for you now. Those who feel so inclined should express their physical joy at the fact of the music. By either doing that or singing along. Anyway, my name's Frank Turner. Thanks a lot for having me and paying attention and all the rest of it. I'm back in the Peel in January, so I'll see you then. Here we go.